Clear signing is achieved using the multi-part content type with a signed subtype. As was mentioned, this signing process does not involve transforming the message to be signed, so that the message is sent in the clear. Thus, recipients with MIME capability but not S/MIME capability are able to read the incoming message. A multi-part signed message has two parts. The first part can be MIME type but must be prepared so that it will not be altered during the transfer from source to destination. This means that if the first part is not 7-bit, then it needs to be encoded using BASE64 or coded printable. Then this part is processed in the same manner as signed data, but in case of an object with signed data format is created that has an empty message content field. This object is detached signature. It is then transfer encoded using BASE64 to become the second part of multi-part signed message. This second part has a MIME content type of application and a subtype of PKCS7 signature. Registration request. Typically, an application or user will apply to a certification authority for a public key certificate. The application PKCS10 S/MIME entity is used to transfer a certification request. The certification request includes certification request info block, followed by an identifier of the public key encryption algorithm, followed by the signature of the certification request info block, which is made using sender's private key. The certification request info block includes a name of the certificate subject, the entity whose public key is to be certified, and a bit string representation of the user's public key. Certificates only message. A message containing only certificates or a certificate revocation list CRL can be sent in response to a registration request. The message is an application PKCS7 MIME type. Type subtype with a S/MIME type parameter of degenerate. The steps involved are the same as those for creating a signed data message, except that there is no message content and the signed info field is empty. S/MIME certificate processing. S/MIME uses public key certificates that conform to version 3 of X.509. The key management scheme used by S/MIME is in some ways a hybrid between a strict X.501 certification hierarchy and PGP's Web of Trust. As with the PGP module, S/MIME managers and/or users must configure each client with a list of trusted keys and with certificate revocation list. This is the responsibility which is local for maintaining the certificates needed to verify incoming signatures and to encrypt outgoing messages. On the other hand, the certificates are signed by certification authorities. A S/MIME user has several key management functions to perform. First one, key generation. The user of some related administrative utility, for example, one associated with the land management, must be capable of generating separate Diffie-Hellman and DSS key pairs and should be capable of generating RSA key pairs. Each key pair must be generated from a good source of non-deterministic random input and be protected in a secure fashion. A user agent should generate RSA key pairs with a length in the range of 768 to 1024 bits and must not generate a length of less than 512 bits. Registration. A user's public key must be registered with a certification authority in order to receive an X.509 public key certificate. Certificate storage and retrieval. A user requires access to a local list of certificates in order to verify incoming signatures and to encrypt outgoing messages. Such a list could be maintained by the user or by some local administrative entity on behalf of a number of users. VeriSign certificates. There are several companies that provide the certification authority, CA services. For example, Nortel has designed an enterprise CA solution and can provide S/MIME support within an organization. There are a number of internet-based CAs, including VeriSign, GTE, and the US Postal Service. Of these, the most widely used one is the VeriSign Certification Authority Service, a brief description of which are as provided. VeriSign certificates provides the certification authority service that is intended to be compatible with S/MIME and a variety of other applications. VeriSign issues X.509 certificates with the product name VeriSign Digital ID. As of early 1998, over 35,000 commercial websites were using VeriSign server digital IDs, and over a million consumer digital IDs had been issued to users of Netscape and Microsoft browsers. The information contained in a digital ID depends on the type of digital ID and its use. At a minimum, each digital ID contains the following: owner's public key, owner's name or alias, expiration date of the digital ID, serial number of the digital ID, name of the certification authority that issued the digital ID, digital signature of the certification authority that issued the digital ID. The digital IDs can also contain other user supplied information, which includes the address, email ID, basic registration information such as the country, zip code, age, and the gender. VeriSign Public Key Certificate Classes. VeriSign provides three levels or classes of security for public key certificates, which are summarized as in the table. A user requests a certificate online at VeriSign's website or other participating websites. Class 1 and Class 2 requests are processed online and in most cases take only a few seconds to approve. Briefly, the following procedures are used. For Class 1 digital IDs, VeriSign confirms the user's email address by sending a PIN and digital ID pickup information to the email address provided in the application. For Class 2 digital IDs, VeriSign verifies the information in the application through an automated comparison with a consumer database, in addition to performing all of the checking associated with Class 1 digital ID. Finally, confirmation is sent to the specified postal address, alerting the user that a digital ID has been issued in his or her name. For Class 3 digital IDs, VeriSign requires a higher level of identity assurance. An individual must prove his or her identity by providing notarized credentials or applying it in person. Enhanced security services. Three enhanced security services have been proposed in an internet draft. The details of this may change and additional services may be added. The three services are signed receipts. A signed reset may be requested in a signed data object. Returning a signed reset provides proof of delivery to the originator of the message and allows the originator to demonstrate to a third party that the recipient received the message. In essence, the recipient signs the entire original message plus the original sender signature and appends the new signature to the form, a new SMIMessage. Security labels. A security label may be included in the authenticated attributes of a signed data object. A security label is a set of security information regarding the sensitivity of the content that is protected by SMIME encapsulation. The labels may be used for access control by indicating which users are permitted access to an object. Other uses include the priority. Priority means to say secret, confidential, restricted, and so on. Or role-based, describing which kind of people can see this information. Example, patients, healthcare team, medical billing agents, and so on. Securing mailing lists. When a user sends a message to multiple recipients, a certain amount of per recipient processing is required, including the use of each recipient's public key. The user can be relieved of this work by employing the service of SMIME mailing list agent, MLA. An MLA can take a single incoming message, perform the recipient-specific encryption for each recipient, and then forward the message. The originator of the message need only the message to MLA with the encryption performed using MLA's public key.